Hello, I'm Vaishali. Today I'm here with a question on transportation problem. This is the second question on Vogel approximation method. You can see my previous videos. I'll share the link. In that I have already discussed one Vogel approximation method. This is the another question on which we are applying the Vogel approximation method. This is the given problem. Determine an initial basic feasible solution using the Vogel approximation method. O stands for the origin. These are the origins, and here these are the destinations, D1, D2, D3 destinations. O1, O2, O3 are origins. This is the cost value. These are the supplies, and these are the demand. So you know that if you have seen my previous video, you know that for Vogel approximation method, you have to first check whether the problem is balanced transportation problem. So first step is to check for balanced transportation problem. So for that we have to sum the supply value. That means 17 plus 12 plus 16. This is step number 1. Is you know that this is equal to 45. Then taking the destination part, 14 plus 8 plus 23. So this is also equal to 45. So as we know that supply and destinations are equal, so this is the balanced matrix. We will write 45 here. Okay. Doing this, we move to the next step. For next step, we have to find the penalties. Penalties related to the cost values for both the side, for supply as well as for the demand values. So for that we have made the first penalty matrix. This is the first penalty matrix where we have to find the penalties of the from the row and for the columns. Okay, don't write reduced, only first penalty matrix. So for finding the first penalty matrix, you have to see the smallest value and the second smallest value. The difference of the two cost values will give you the value of penalty. Like here, 15 minus 13 will give you the value as 2. Then next, 7 and 2. So 7 minus 2 will give you the penalty value as 5. Then here, 19 and 9. Likewise, you have to do for column value so that you can find the penalty for column. So 7 and 13. So 13 minus 7. No need to write this. Only I am writing it so that you can understand how I am writing or how I am finding the penalties for the required row. Okay. So here 13 minus 7 is 6. Now here 11 and 15. Then 9 minus 2 is 7. So these are the required penalties for row and the column. After finding the required penalties for the row and the column, you have to find the maximum penalty. So first step is to find the maximum penalty. Which is the maximum penalty value? 10. 10 is the maximum penalty. So after finding the maximum penalty in that row or the selected column, here maximum penalty is the row penalty. So for that you have to find the maximum value. You have to find the least cost value. Maximum penalty you have find. After finding the maximum penalty, you have to find the least cost value. The least cost value is 9. Okay. So minimum cost value. Minimum cost value is 9. So after finding the minimum cost value, you have to find the maximum allocated value for this cell. How much we can allocate maximum to this cell? 16 is the supply and 23 is the demand. So maximum we can provide this to 16. We can do maximum value. We can allocate maximum to 16. So allocated value is 16. Okay, after writing 16 here, supply is satisfied, but it is still left with 7 values. Okay, now after writing means supply is satisfied, that means this row is to be crossed. We cross out this row. Now only this is remaining. So we have to write this small matrix here. So this will become the new reduced matrix, new reduced penalty matrix. You have to copy it as such. 7, 11, 12. The destinations will remain as such. The origins remain as such. That means row and the column will be copied as. Now supply is 17 and 12. The last one is crossed out. Now here is 14, 8 and new supply is, new demand is 7. Okay. So this is your new reduced penalty matrix. After writing the new reduced penalty matrix, again you have to find the penalty. Penalty is the difference of the two smallest, means smallest, and the second smallest cost value. Here 15 minus 13 is 2. Here 12 minus 7 is 5. Okay, no need to write this. You can do it by yourself. 13 minus 7 is 6. Then 15 and 11 is 4. Here it is 4. Okay. Oh, this is 2. So this is 2. Sorry for that. This is 14. So maximum penalty you have to find first. First step is, after writing the penalty, first step is to find the maximum penalty. The maximum penalty is, what is the maximum penalty? 2, 5, 6, 4 and 14. So maximum penalty is 14. After finding the maximum penalty, see, in first case we got maximum penalty which is pointing to the row. Here we got the maximum penalty which is pointing to the column. So in the same column we have to find the minimum cost value. Okay, so minimum cost value is 2. Then give the maximum allocation to this. Allocated value. How much we can allocate to this cell? 7 and 12. So maximum value we can give to this cell is 7. That means maximum allocation we can do of the value is 7. So after allocating 7, demand is satisfied. Here it is still left with 5. Okay. Now that means this column is crossed out. Okay. Now we get the new reduced third matrix. So this is the new reduced third matrix. After writing here the values, we will going to copy it from here. Okay, that means 13. The same you have to copy D1, D2, O1, O2. Then 15, then 7, 11. Now the new supply is 17 and 5. Here 14 and 8. Okay, now you have to find the new penalty values. New penalty values is again the difference of the two. Here you are having only the two values. That means you can directly subtract. 15 minus 13 is 2. Then 11 minus 7 is 5. Then 13 minus 7 is 6. Here 15 minus 11 is 4. So maximum penalty value 2, 5, 6 and 4. So the maximum penalty value is 6. So maximum penalty is 6. That means this is selected. So this value is pointing towards the column. That means we have to find the cost value. That is the minimum cost value for this column. 7 is the minimum cost value. 7 is the minimum cost value. When you find the cost value, then you have to allocate the panel. You have to give the allocation to this cell 5 and 40. So maximum we can allocate to this cell is value of 5. So after allocating this, the row is satisfied. That means the supply value is satisfied. But it is still left with 9 values. Demand. Demand is still left with 9 values. So that means now row is crossed out. Okay. So now as I told you in my previous videos, that this is the last step. No need to make any new penalty value. No need to make new matrix and search the penalty, because we cannot. This is only one row we left. So here only we can do. This is the maximum penalty. This is pointing towards this column. This is done. Row is crossed out, but we can still have one value in the column. So we will first allocate this column value. This is 13. So how much we can allocate? Next minimum cost value is 13. Okay. Next minimum cost value is 13. 9 and 17. We can allocate to this cell is maximum to 9 value. This becomes 0, but this is still left with 8 values. Okay? When this is still left with 8 values, that means now we have to do the allocation for this cost value. This is only the last remaining cost value. The maximum value we can allocate this to 8. This becomes 0, this becomes 0. So all supply is satisfied, all demand value is satisfied. Okay. Minimum cost value or the last value, you can write it as 50. So after doing this, you have to make the final allocated cost matrix. This is now write it like this: O1, D2, it is 15, the cost value, allocated value is 8, O1, D1, 13 is the cost value, allocated value is 9, O2, D1, allocated value is 5, okay? Then here, O2, D3, O2, D3, allocated value is 7. Then here, O3, D3, allocated value is 16 and cost value is 9. So, okay. These are the 5 allocations, O2, D1, then O1, D1, then these 3, then O3, D3. And the last one is O2, D3. Okay. These are the 5 allocations. That means this is the final allocated cost matrix. Then after that, you have to find the total transportation cost. Total transportation cost is the multiplication of individual cost value to the individual allocated value. Okay. That means 9 into 13 plus 8 into 15. I am doing it row wise. Then 5 into 7. Then 7 into 2. Plus 16 into 9. So this value is rupees 430. You can calculate it. The total cost value is 430. Okay. So this is your question. You have to apply the Vogel approximation method to find the transportation cost for the given transportation matrix. Okay. So initial basic feasible solution we obtain is rupees 430. Hope you understand this. Please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.